Hey brothers and sisters, it's me. I'm making several videos. I don't know what all I'll post. Here I am walking at the orphanage. We just did the memory verses and the presentation and the games and all that. Anyway, I want to talk to you guys about, to advance the orphanage. The Lord has talked to me about planting several more orphanages, maybe in the whole world, particularly starting here in the Philippines, maybe other third world countries. It's up to the Lord. And so I made videos about that. I ask you guys to continue to pray about that. I've been getting a year tally of the loans we've made on these coconut farms. I've been talking about that. Some of you guys have donated for that. And right now we got about a 20% return on our investment, which is really good on the coconut farm. That's, net. No, besides any kind of expenses, taxes or whatnot. We have about a 20% return. And the coconut prices are down right now at historical low. They may go up, and they usually go up around, different times, up to where we would even make a 50% return on our money. But right now we're about 20% a year this first year. So our net profit of what we people have donated for, we made about $2,000 this year. Make about $2,000 a year on what we have so far. So I think for one orphanage, I think we need about $20,000 a year for the operation here to maintain it. All the things that we're doing now. And so I ask you guys to pray about that. I'd like to, get more coconut farmland to get up that, so we need 10 times as much. And then by the grace of God, we're going to open 2 more orphanages this year. That's my prayer, my belief, that at least 2 more orphanages we can do this year. I've already got the house, mom and dad, for both the other 2 locations. The Lord has already lined it up. I've got the pastors to oversee the spiritual aspects of it lined up to do a church in each orphanage. Now all we need is the finances to come together. And the land and all that, I think we already got all that looking good too. So just pray about it if you want to help me get involved to continue to do the Lord's work here. As the foundation of Joshua's ministry, as a little child shall lead them. And just like Joshua, he led his people into the promised land, that these children, the Lord tarries, which we don't know when the Lord's coming back. Could be tomorrow, could be 20 years from now. That these young people is going to be the future leaders of the church. Lead their relatives, their friends, their neighborhood, where they came from. These kids are from all different kinds of poor areas of the Philippines. They can speak different native dialects. They're going to go back to their own area where they came from and reap a harvest for God's glory in the next few years, 5 to 10 years. And in the meantime, we're doing the Lord's will until He returns. I ask you to pray about it. If you can want to get involved in donating, do it. If you don't have any money, pray that others will. Pray for this so we can press forward, grow Joshua's ministry, and do the Lord's will here in the Philippines. As you know, brothers and sisters, the Lord has opened the door for me to do lots of ministry work in the States. I'm getting tons of invitations from all around the world, and I want to go to every one of those places and do it. So by the grace of God, the thing that I need is good laborers here to work with me in the harvest, pastors, good pastors, house moms and dads. We already got the ones for this next 2 orphanages. We need more pastors. We need, more financing, all those things to go forward and do the work of the Lord. All of it is, we don't have any overhead here. I give a nominal salary to the house mom and dad, a nominal salary, nothing like what you see in the States with all these administrators. You talk about all these big organizations in the States that you see on television, that you can, if you go Google and look at their overhead, like the Red Cross and all that kind of stuff. One thing, Red Cross is not Christian anyway. It's a non-profit organization. If you look at any of these Christian organizations, they're also a non-profit organization. And they're involved in raising money from big companies that are not Christian. It's all about corporate, donations for tax purposes for these corporations. So there's lots of compromise in all those things. Plus, they have huge salaries for these administrators and all this stuff. So that's why, if you want to bypass all this foolishness, bypass the red tape, really see the gospel going straight to where it needs to go. There's other ministries, not just Joshua's ministry. Joshua's ministry is one of them. And there's another brother here who's not a pastor. He's a businessman, Joey, Brother Joey, in the same island as I talked to you about. He's getting orphans together for us to go in these new orphanages from the place that was devastated by the typhoon. So God bless you guys. I'll make more videos about this. The administrative and the sellout and the compromise and the watered down message to get all of these, things that they do through these big international organizations ends up where the gospel has no effect, where they're not even preaching the gospel. That's what ends up happening. All, you know, 70% of the money or whatever it is goes to all this administrative cost and pay all these high-paid lawyers and administrators to go begging money from Microsoft and people like that are atheists anyway. Now, you can imagine, if you go to Microsoft and say, can you give us $10 million to do some aid in the Philippines, do you think you're going to turn around at the same time you got one hand out asking for money, you're going to start evangelizing Bill Gates, who's an atheist? No, you can't. It's a conflict of interest. So the whole thing ends up becoming a business and a corporate thing and not the work of the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you guys. God bless you. Thank you for your prayers. God bless. Merry Christmas.